gentlemen. Caldabarber. I'm here in my mobile barber shop. And as promised by the title, I'm going to be teaching you guys the steps to making $100,000 plus cutting hair. Now, there are a lot of factors involved, but there's a few major ones that if you do these steps and you take it very seriously, you will easily be able to make over 100 grand a year cutting hair. So let's get started here. Number one is consistency. I can't talk enough about consistency and being persistent when it comes to the barber world or any business world for that matter. When you're consistent, you're telling the client they can rely on you. You're telling the client that no matter when they need you, you're available. So when you have that type of reliability, people tend to come to you more often. You're their first choice. You're the first call. You may be their only call. But going back to before you get these clients, how to gain clientele. If you're working in a regular barbershop, which is where I started, and after that, I had a regular barbershop because now, as you can see, I'm inside of my mobile barbershop. I do this full time now. But before that was a reality, I worked in a regular barbershop. And I started out as someone who was fresh out of the penitentiary. No one knew me as a barber. They knew me as a you know, drug dealer. So it was hard getting people to warm up to the idea of, hey, he's not in the streets no more. He's not a dope boy. Now he's actual barber. So that was a struggle, but I was consistent. I sat in that shop every day for 12-hour days every single day until I built a clientele. How'd I build them? When they got my chair, they didn't get back out of it. How'd I ensure that? I gave more in value and service than I asked for in money. If I was giving them back then, I was charging $20 for a haircut. Now I was actually charging $15 for a haircut back then. So if I'm charging $15 for a haircut, I'm giving you $30 worth of haircut. I'm using the razor. I'm doing all the extras for you that everyone's charging extra for, because if you give them more, they're going to come back. You ever hear more bang for your buck? Well, give people more bang for their buck. If you're just giving people the minimum and then asking them for $25, which nowadays $25, $30, you're giving them a $10 haircut for $30, and that's not the way to build clientele. Give more in service. Then you receive the money. You'll always have plenty of money because they'll tip you. So, as far as the numbers, we're going to go back to this, but the numbers. Now, let's play a numbers game now. What does it take to make 100 grand a year? Okay, let's do the math real fast. If you can charge $30 for a haircut, do only 10 haircuts a day, work 6 days a week, it's $1,800 a week. $1,800 a week. Times that by 52 weeks in a year, you're at 100 grand. 10 haircuts a day. I don't know how many haircuts you're doing now. If you're fresh out of school, that may be the minimum of what you, or the max of what you're doing. If you're a veteran barber, you should be doing at least 20. If you're a slow, regular, average barber. If you're somebody like me, I do a lot more. That's because I'm a lot quicker. Once again, if you're a barber like myself, I'm a lot faster. You have to train yourself to be faster at cutting hair. That's done by consistently being cognizant, paying attention to your time. When your person gets in your chair, you look at your watch. Okay, quarter of. They get in the chair, you cut them. You look, all right, it's 1:15. That took me a half hour to do. Can I get faster? Then you start breaking down what things you can do to be faster. I'm actually going to do a video about how to be a fast and precise barber and cut more heads. I'm going to do a video about that, but that's not today. So minimum 10 heads a day. That means you're doing basically a haircut in a half an hour. If you work an 8-hour day, that's not a lot. Because some of the haircuts you're going to get are going to be faster. So just look at it like that. That's the numbers game. But how do you build the clientele? How do you get the people in your chair? Once again, it goes back to consistency. Because I remember when I was working in the first barbershop I worked at, I was there so much, they thought I owned the place. But a lot of people did, but I didn't. And one thing that that would happen was you'd have this barber right here, okay, which could be the owner, could be another barber in the shop. They're here, I'm right here. This guy wants to work 3-4 days a week, I work 7. This guy wants to get off at 5, I get off at 9 o'clock. So when these clients come walking in that have been dealing with this guy, and they're looking for him, and he's nowhere to be found, which they're gonna be walkouts. If I'm not there, they're a walkout. So he's gonna lose them regardless. But I'm able to keep them there because I'm there. Hey, I could cut, come sit in my chair. Come, I got you. Be confident, get them in your chair and do the best haircut you could possibly do. And continue to do the best haircut you could possibly do. Don't get a client and then start slacking or give them less than what you gave them the first time. A lot of barbers make that mistake. They'll give them all the perfect, wonderful treatment in the beginning, and once they get them or they get more clientele, they start slacking. Be able to give the same exact service repetitively to all your clients all the time. Now, a lot of people want to get maximum results without having maximum effort. It doesn't work that way. It's just like looking at a fireplace and saying, okay, fireplace, I want you to give me all the heat you can. If you could do that, I'll throw some wood in there. No, it doesn't work that way. You have to throw the wood in first, then receive the heat. Same thing with success. You got to give maximum effort for maximum result. Maximum wood, maximum heat, maximum effort, maximum results. That's how it works. If you're only putting 10% in, you're going to get 10% back. If you put 110% back, you'll get 110% in, you're going to get 110% back. It's what you put into it. If you're a barber right now and you're watching this video, ask yourself honestly, do a very honest self-evaluation of yourself. Are you working those 6 days a week? Are you working those hours a day? Are you getting up early in the morning, getting in the shop first thing? Are you taking that time? Because you're probably all wasting my time just sitting waiting in the shop. Well, you know what? You're waiting for that one client. That's it. If you can get a new client every day, let's do some more math. This is how I thought of it. I said, okay, I got a year to get myself on. So I'm going to get me one new client a day for a year. 365 days in a year, that's 365 clients if you get one new client a day. You don't even need that many clients to make the money that I'm telling you about. Because you're going to get people that's going to come every week, every 2 weeks. Some are going to be every 3 to a month, but most of them every week, 2 weeks. Do the math. If you can't get one person in your chair a day, one new person, then you don't deserve it. You only deserve what you work for. If you're not getting that kind of money right now and you're not making the money you want to make right now, you don't deserve it. And I hate to say it, and I hate to make you feel like you don't deserve it, but you don't. You didn't work for it. You can't make money. You earn it. You earn money. Money is earned. The only people that make money work in a mint. If you don't work in a mint, you're not making money. You're earning it. You earn it by working, by being available, by being reliable, by giving great service. That's how you make that money. And once you get to that 100 grand, that's going to be pennies to you, because once you get the rhythm of being consistent and being disciplined, you're going to be making so much money, you'll be swimming. I promise you. I promise you. That's a fact. I don't care where you live. I'm in Harrisburg. Harrisburg is not a big city. There's people in Philly, Baltimore, New York. There's people in Atlanta that don't make what I make because they're not consistent. Doesn't matter where you're at. You can be in a small town. As long as there's people you can cut, you can make the money, because everybody needs haircuts. Everybody needs to get their haircut. Unless you're just growing an afro or they're growing a ponytail or something. But maybe you'll still get a lineup. But that goes back into cards. If you are watching this video and you do not have a business card, get a business card, because that's your number one way of building clientele, because it's the quickest way to pass your information along, and it's a very good icebreaker without, you know, just walking up on people telling, hey, I cut hair, write my number down. That just doesn't work that way. Walk up on them and say, hey, my name is so-and-so. I'm a great barber. Here's my card. Check me out. I'm very reliable and consistent. Now, see, why do I use that word? Why I say it to people? I'm very reliable, most reliable barber you'll ever meet. I tell people that because in the back of their head, their barber's not consistent. 9 times out of 10, the barber's not consistent or reliable. So when I tell them that, oh, it's reliable, it's consistent. Then they do their background, they see that I am. Oh, they're gonna give me a shot. That's all I need is a shot. You gotta get them in the chair. Once you get them in the chair, the rest is history. If you do the things I just told you to do. I'm telling you, it's very, very easy to make 100 grand cutting hair. If you can't make 100 grand cutting hair, doing the things I said, you didn't do the things I said. Follow the instructions to the letter. Work often. Work long. Work hard. And to the point. Work often. Work. Go to work. Go to work. Stop thinking you can work 2-3 days a week in the beginning. It doesn't work that way. Stop thinking you gotta work a part-time job. For what? They're paying you pennies. For the amount they're paying you, you can make that in 5 minutes, 10 minutes. Know your worth as well. Always know your worth. If you know that you're giving a great service, you're doing the things I told you to do in this video, you're actually worth $30, $40, $50 for a haircut. And as you grow in your talents, as you grow in your knowledge of barbering, as you get better, quicker, sharper, you're going to be worth even more. Your worth only can grow as you allow it to, meaning the work you put in. So I'm going to be doing more videos coming up, some more videos about how to be a faster barber, how to increase your speed, videos on how to actually effectively present yourself to new and potential clients, how to conduct yourself in a barbershop setting where you can draw people to your chair, because a lot of people have that problem too. I'm going to say that really quickly. If you're a new barber and you can't get people in your chair, you just got to put yourself out there. Just walk up to them. Hey, how you doing? Hey, if you know that they're not going to anybody else's chair, they're just a walk-in. Hey, how you doing? My name's Calvin. Come on, sit in my chair. I got you, man. I'm good. Then make them feel comfortable. Don't be like sitting there like, should I cut their hair? No, they're gonna catch on to that vibe. They're going to get in your chair. You're messing with their hair, man. Be confident. Even if you're not the best barber in your mind, pretend you are, because eventually you will be. I always pretended that, even when I wasn't that good. Come on. I got you. I'm doing all this. I'm cape and all that, and you know, trying to be off. Man, look, I wasn't even that good, but eventually they didn't know the difference because I did the best I could, and they felt the vibe, they felt the energy, and you know, here I am today. I'm doing very well, and we'll continue to do that. Also going to be doing videos about how to open your own mobile barbershop. That's coming soon. If I'm being honest, I'm still figuring it out myself. I'm doing very well, but I'm still tweaking things and figuring things out, because it's a whole different genre. It's nothing like working in the shop. It's totally different. Different sense of responsibility. It's a lot more involved. It's not easy, but it's very rewarding, and I think it's fun. I love it. I love the cut. So it's for me. It may not be for you, but we'll see when you watch the video. So please subscribe. Please subscribe. I need all these subscribers I can get. Share it with somebody that you know that needs to hear these things, and we'll keep going. And you know, also got Barber Bus Talk that airs every week on YouTube as well. Look that up too. It's pretty interesting. We do different barbershop type talking. No political, nothing race related, nothing serious to that degree. We try to keep it light. But watch me. Appreciate you guys. Love y'all. And keep going.